It's whether or not you think geometry has any kind of relationship with consciousness. Because when, for instance, if you look at pi, and correct me if I'm wrong on any of this, this is just stuff I found research, but it's a non-repeating decimal number, which would mean that it has every possible combination and bits of data to create any code for our experiences. And it seems like it could possibly be like a kind of like a DNA for consciousness. And I just find it interesting. I see there's a lot of ancient stone megaliths around the world that are circles within circles and within circles, and even crop circles are very common. It just reminds me of process fractals or cellular automata that you've said before could possibly evolve themselves to become a general purpose computer. Just wanted to get your ideas on that. I know it's probably on the level of conjecture, but felt like asking anyways.
Yeah. Okay. Well, you're right that pi, you know, is a value that has decimal places that never repeat, and they go on and on and on. There's no end to those decimal places. That doesn't necessarily mean that all the combinations and permutations of digits are there. Or maybe that is, perhaps you might say that in a theoretical sense, but not in any practical sense. There's not a practical sense where you can apply that sort of thing to, you know, say all the codes in it. I wouldn't say that. It isn't really a useful way of looking at it. But mathematics is an integral part of the rule set. After all, this is a virtual reality, and it's computed. Well, it has to be computed with rules. Rules are what we call mathematics. Mathematics is a bunch of rules. You know, how do you? It's actually our math that we have, that we know in our reality, is it's the logic of quantity. The quantity has certain logics. Like if you got two apples and two oranges, you have four fruit. You know, that's just the logic of quantity. So that's what math is. So we have this rule set that defines how things can interact. And math is a large part of that rule set, how it works, how things connect. What are the logical consequences of one thing interacting with another thing? All that is mathematically computed. That's why science, physics in particular, models reality with mathematics, because they find out that's a very good way to model reality. So physicists are basically applied mathematicians. They take the mathematics and they apply it and say, this mathematics describes reality. That's because reality is computed. You see, so if it's computed, then math is the natural way to describe it. That's why physics is a math, really, an applied math, more than anything else. So geometry, and consciousness are connected in the sense that our virtual reality, okay, is developed or is generated by a rule set which is mathematically based. So you wouldn't be surprised to find things in our virtual reality that follow mathematical sequences, you know, Fibonacci sequence, lots of things. Keep, you know, the golden mean. These things come up over and over and over again as you look at our it's what's going on here in the details of the structures of things. Well, that's because they work. Those things work. They are things that help describe this virtual reality. Equations and geometry that the circle pi, you know, it's a relationship between, you know, the circumference and the diameter of a circle. You know, well, circle is a fundamental piece of geometry. It's inclusive. You know, circles, you'll find those all over, not because really it's the circle so much as it's the concept of circle, like in Venn diagrams, where circles denote, you know, what's inside of a system. And where some systems overlap, you'll have two circles, and part of those two circles will overlap. So they describe those kinds of things. So it's not really the geometry of the circle so much as it is the idea of what's included within a boundary. It's just nicer to do those with circles instead of doing them with, other things. Just, you could do it with stars and where the little star points overlap, you could do that, but it's just not, it doesn't lend itself as well, to the explanation and to trying to explain something or see something. So a lot of this kind of sacred geometry, it's not really sacred. There's nothing sacred about it. It's not, sacred in the normal sense of that word. It's just that it is those equations and mathematics that have shown themselves or that have with evolution been very, very useful in describing this physical reality. So we see them applied over and over again. Kind of reminds me when I was doing simulations, one of my favorite things was ellipsoids. I use ellipsoids, it's an ellipse. You can make it flat, you can make it a line, you can make it a circle. You can do all kinds of things with it. And I used ellipsoids to make people, airplanes, helicopters. I could model almost anything. And about 90% of the shapes I used were ellipsoids because you can stack them to do almost everything, roughly. So somebody who looked at my simulations would say that, oh, the ellipsoids were sacred, in my calculations. They weren't really sacred to me. They just happened to be really useful. Because they, they did a lot of things. Because in nature, you don't find many 90-degree corners. There's hardly any sharp corners anywhere in nature. Nature just doesn't construct a lot of things, in a box shape. So curve things just fit better in describing nature. So it's not so much that the geometry is sacred as it just turned out to be really useful. So it gets used over and over again. And yes, this is a fractal reality, which means the stuff that works continues on and gets applied more. And it the same things that are, the same things that are at the, in our evolution, it's a conscious evolution fractal. So in those things where the evolution of consciousness and this virtual reality is part of that, the stuff that works then gets used more. So you do, you see the same things reoccurring and reoccurring because that's part of the evolution of the process. So that's all. The sacred is kind of a metaphor that I'd say really means special. And it's special just because you see it all over because it just happens to work well. That's all. It's just a practical way of doing the things that the rule set did in our evolution. At least that's my perspective on it. That's a lot of hand waving, but there's nothing really too magic about mathematics. It's just logic, just relationships. It's relationships of quantity, logical, the logic of relationships in quantities. And you can have some neat little things like the golden mean that can just generate a lot of nifty shape.